Hey everyone, it's OSK, and today I have the Near Replicant Easy Combat Guide. With this video, I will be going over every combat mechanic in Near Replicant version 1.22, yada yada yada. Seriously, square root of 1.5, who thinks of this? And show you some cool techniques that I learned from playing the game for 13 hours. We'll start with the basics of combat in the beginning, and then we'll be getting into some more advanced techniques that I use on stream now that you can plug right into your own Near Replicant gameplay. Now, real quick before we get started, if you think I do a good job, please consider leaving a like on the video and subscribe for more Near Replicant content if you'd like to see more. Now that that's out of the way though, let's get into this. Like I said earlier, first we'll go over the basics. If you come from Near Automata or any similar action beat-em-up style game, you'll feel right at home here. In Near Replicant, the player is equipped with a melee weapon, magic spells from Grimoire Vice, a dodging mechanic, and a slew of different word edits or bonuses that can be equipped to each of these. There is also a lock-on mechanic you can use to help you stay focused on one opponent. I play on PC so don't use it all that much, but it can still come in handy here and there. A lot of these can be interwoven between each other to make for some stunning combos and interesting interactions, so stay tuned for all those. Starting with melee weapons, this is the bread and butter of the combat system in Near Replicant. Different melee weapons can be found throughout the game world, and each of them grant Near different strings of combo chains and various effects. Every melee weapon comes with light attacks, heavy attacks, and the ability to block or parry attacks. Light attacks allow the player to start off combos quickly and easily, while heavy attacks give that extra oomph for your attacks for knockdowns and launches. Additionally, blocking can be performed to mitigate damage from any enemy you are facing. This means if you get hit from the side or the back, you will take full damage. But if you're quick and face the right direction, you will block most every bit of damage that comes your way. Now, timing a block right when an attack hits you is key, as it will allow you to parry and counterattack to dish out huge amounts of damage. This can be done with just about any attack, although you can still take damage if the enemy is too strong for you at the moment. One thing the game does not tell you a whole lot about is aerial combat, specifically launching. Launching an enemy is done with all weapons by jumping and then quickly using a heavy attack. Once you're in the air, you can then string together some light attacks to keep the combo going, and then heavy attack again to slam the opponent down to the ground in an AoE blast around Near. This is especially important for knocking down your opponents, which will let you perform a finishing move. A finishing move is done by using your main interact button on a downed opponent. For PC, I use the F key, and for controller, the circle or B button for PlayStation and Xbox. This will allow Near to channel his inner stabby stab and finish off opponents very quickly once they're knocked down. This is great for dealing with hordes of enemies very quickly, as it is almost an insta-kill when performed and saves you a lot of time when trying to kill off enemies one by one. One of my favorite combos I picked up is launching an opponent into the air, slamming them back down to the ground for a knockdown, and then performing a finishing move. It's that simple and works on pretty much everything except for larger bosses. That about covers everything for the melee portion of the guide. Let's get into some magic. To start with magic, or Grimoire Vice, whatever you like to call the old talking book, let's get down to basics. Magic is a very handy tool to use against ranged opponents and boss monsters alike. With the correct sealed verses or spells, you'll be able to hit enemies without ever getting in harm's way. There is a wide variety of spells to use in Master, however, I will only cover the three that I use in my game the most: Dark Blast, Dark Lance, and Dark Hand. Dark Blast is essentially the machine gun or pea shooter of the game and mainly helps to maximize DPS or take care of most of those annoying floating orbs. The only drawback is it does slow your running speed, but you can still evade and attack just fine, so you can definitely use it alongside your normal combos for some extra damage. Dark Lance is like the beefed up daddy version of Dark Blast and launches a magical spear looking thing in a target direction. An important thing to note is that these bigger spells can be charged up for a greater effect. The obvious effect for Dark Lance is creating more lances to throw at your opponents. This is really useful for getting out quick, big damage and is especially useful against larger opponents. Now, my personal favorite of all the spells is Dark Hand, and I'll tell you why. This is easily the best stun and knockdown tool in the entire game in my opinion, and it also hits in a big AoE and breaks through armor, which is really useful for hordes of enemies. You don't even need to charge it up, but you can to add some more hands and more damage if you want. This really opens enemies up to finishing moves and just overall is a great tool in any arsenal. There are other spells you can use too, but these are the most useful in my book, and you unlock them fairly early as well, which is nice. Adding on to this is evading and sidestepping attacks. This can be done in combat by pressing the shift key on PC or right trigger on controller. Evading allows you to completely dodge any damage from the opponent and gives you some iframes or invincibility to pass through some otherwise sure hits from monsters and bosses. There is no stamina bar in the game as well, so you can spam evade in a pinch if you need to. This can also be done mid-air and in the game world for some extra speed. In fact, evading forward is actually faster than sprinting if you care to know that. Getting into sidestepping, this is a very easy mechanic to master, but also a very important one as it will help you avoid damage even in bigger fights. To sidestep, simply evade in the direction of your opponent to circle around them for a better angle. It truly is that simple. The trick is knowing when to sidestep and when not to, as some attacks can cover wide areas, so a bit of practice will go a long way. Some extra little tools that add to the combat are words, which affect things such as MP regen, physical damage buffs, defense buffs, and that sort of thing. To get there, go into your menu under Grimoire Vice and select your preferred words for your preferred magic, weapons, and martial arts. Some words give special effects like apply poison or paralyze to a weapon. I personally get a lot of use out of paralyze as it helps me set up for a knockdown and finishing move combo very easily. You can collect these by defeating different shades in the game world, and some words require different specific shades to unlock, so be sure to slaughter all that you see. Now I did say that I'd get into some advanced tips in the beginning, and I've pretty much laid the groundwork for all this in each section, but I'll wrap it up all nicely here in the final section. To start, when using your weapon, light attacks and heavy attacks usually will not stop an enemy from attacking you. You can see the shades I'm hitting are still able to hit me whenever they're being cut down. I'd like to throw in a block or a preemptive sidestep to avoid getting hit. Another tip you might like is to be sure to launch enemies into the air as much as possible. By being in the air, you're able to avoid most of the enemies on the ground, which will help a lot when dealing with hordes of enemies. Whenever you slam them back to earth, you'll oftentimes knock down multiple enemies, which will let you spam your finishing move and take them out very quickly. One last tip I'll give you here is to master the Dark Hand spell. This thing is so useful for staggering and knocking down enemies, it's not even funny. You don't even need to charge it up either, it's that good. By mastering Dark Hand and the rest of combat, you can literally take down this boar while fighting a horde without even needing a rock because he will never get the chance to charge at you, even on hard mode. It's actually insane. This kind of stun lock does happen with other enemies as well, so experiment to your heart's content, but man is it strong. And that is going to wrap up the Easy Combat Guide for Nier Replicant version whatever. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I really do hope you guys enjoyed the video and learned a bit more about the combat system for the game. It took me 13 hours of in-game time to sift through all these mechanics and master them, so with this guide, I hope you won't have to take that long. Now, like I said at the start, if you enjoyed the video and think I did a good job, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more Nier Replicant content. I plan on making quite a bit of it, so stay tuned for that, and all gameplay footage is recorded for my streams, so if that's something you're interested in watching, be sure to follow me on Twitter and join the Discord for regular updates on when I'm going live. But that's going to do it for me, guys. I've been OSK, y'all have a great day, and I'll see you all out there.